Jake? I thought it was you. How's it going, man?
Good. You?
Pretty good. Heard you quit the team. Didn't see you at practice.
Yeah, I just didn't have enough time.
Got her ass kicked by Menominee. Could've used you.
Sorry.
All right, man. See you later.
See ya.
Yeah. On your perception, it is what it is. There's the situation. If you're used to it, it's no big deal. If you're not, maybe it is. Perception and the event.
Very late.
Sorry.
Runs is I got six things to do. Those six things should take about 15 minutes. It takes 3 minutes.
Take my bar, police.
Hey, some dude was looking for you earlier.
What dude?
Like a hipster guy with glasses.
Hey, buddy. It's Eli. I had some free time today, so I thought I'd stay by campus and I'd talk to you more about that project I'm working on. So it's about 3 now. If you get this, I'll be in the student center for about an hour.
Hey.
Hey.
Jake, what's up, man? It's good to see you.
Good to see you.
I'm glad you found me. Is this it's like the cool hangout spot?
Yeah, I do homework here a few times a week.
Yeah? Hey, what's your major again?
I don't really know yet.
Okay. You got baptized recently, didn't you?
Last week.
Oh, dude, that's great. I wish I could have been there. Okay, so I'm just gonna jump right into it. You might have heard through the church grapevine, but my family and I were moving to Chicago to start a new Bright Horizons branch.
Cool.
Yeah. God's doing some crazy stuff. But anyway, the church won't launch until the end of the summer, but I thought it might be a good idea to get us started off on the right foot. So we're looking to get a group of guys together, full of passion, full of energy for Jesus, and really build some buzz, build the congregation. We're going to call it an evangelism internship, and I want you to be a part of it.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm the right guy for that. I mean, I've only been coming to church for like a couple months.
Well, you see, that's the thing, is that it's not just about building the church, it's about building you guys as well.
I'll ask my dad about it, but I want to know how much it'll cost.
Hey, why don't you ask Mom? Is she the softie?
She passed away.
I'm really sorry to hear that. Well, it's going to be a really great summer, so I really hope you'll join us if you can. Why don't you pray about it and get back to me? You have my number, so you can just Facebook me or whatever you need to do, okay?
Okay.
I'll see you, buddy.
you know, Kirill is going to be in and out of town, so if you get a chance, she'd love to see you. Just tell him what the pastor, the sea like guy.
No, they're putting us up with families from the church.
You know the family?
How would I?
I got him. Okay, I'll let him know. Later. Jake.
Is it Jake or Jacob?
Just Jake.
Well, welcome to Chicago, Just Jake. So you're all the way here from Wisconsin, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't even know we had churches out there, man. What is it to do in Wisconsin?
I don't know.
You don't know. Don't worry, man. I'm just messing with you. You're probably like, who is this dude? Don't worry, Jake. We're going to have a good time this summer. Welcome to my humble abode. To the left of you, the living room, the bathroom, laundry, and then the kitchen. And right over here, your room.
Yeah, I think I'm here. Which place is it?
Stop. I see you. Not creepy.
Well, Jake. What's up, dude?
Hey, Eli.
Good to see you, man.
Hey,
nice. You look great. Cool.
Hey, anyone come on in?
We got pizza. We got the whole nine yards.
Hey, guys. Everybody, this is Jake. We're about ready to get started. It looks like the pizza's ready, so just go ahead and grab a slice and come back over here. I'll give you the whole Braveheart speech, all right?
I'm Phil.
Jake.
We're rooming together, right?
At Drew's?
Yeah. Cool, man. Iron sharpens iron. Let's get to it.
Men, welcome to boot camp. You are all officially soldiers of Jesus. Let's start by opening up our Bibles. Go to Isaiah 6.
Isaiah
Isaiah's vision from God.
There we go.
Brad, you got it. Why don't you start us out?
In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple.
Mike, continue. Oh, Mike R. We have two mics. That's going to be confusing this summer, I guarantee it.
Above him were seraphs, each with six wings. With two wings they covered their faces, with two they covered their feet, and with two they were flying. And they were calling to one another, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory."
Jake, why don't you take us home?
And he touched my mouth and said, "Behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away, and your sin is atoned for." And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send, and who will go for us?" Then I said, "Here I am, send me."
Here I am, send me. That is going to be your battle cry this summer. We're going to meet here every day, we're going to worship every day, and then we are going to hit the streets. We're going to find people, and we're going to bring them home to Christ. Think you're tough enough?
You know it, Eli, dog.
All right. All right, so take the rest of the day, get some rest, and we'll start again early tomorrow.
Oh, wow. This is really comfortable. Are you sure you're good on the floor?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Just let me know if you ever want to switch.
Okay.
All right, you mind if I get the lights?
No.
Cool. Big day tomorrow.
You come in. Good morning.
Good morning.
How do you like your coffee?
Black's fine.
Got it. Here you go, buddy. Some Chicago Joe. That should get you started.
For you who obey me, my saving power will rise on you like the sun and bring healing like the sun's rays. You will be as free and happy as calves let out of a stall.
And when I'm afraid, I'll put my trust in you, in my God whose name I praise. Yes, God, amen. We can spread it throughout the world with our peers and our brethren. Please, Lord, let us be the light.
We're here.
Yes, Lord, feel you.
We're here, God. Did I meet you at the annual conference last year?
What's the annual conference?
Dude, you don't know what the annual conference is? This dude doesn't know what the annual conference is. It's like a 24/7 Jesus party in Ann Arbor. People come from Brighton Horizon churches from all over the Midwest. I know, I've seen this guy there. Yeah?
Never miss it. Seen Dan Fogelman's talk last year.
Dude, that was amazing. Dan the man, Fogelman. You know, me and Danny Boy have had some good times.
So, can someone tell me, what is evangelism?
Telling people about God?
That's exactly what it is. It is our basic duty as Christians, which is to tell other people about God. Now, a lot of Christians, they don't do this. They think it's unimportant, but I would say that it is our most important duty, and I want each of you to tell me about your story of salvation. Start with Mike R. Go ahead.
I was raised a Christian, but I didn't really take it seriously until Bible camp. I had really bad dyslexia, and God healed me. And after that, I got super serious.
Okay, well, that's good. What I want you to do is be more specific about the why. So it's a big part of what we want. All right, let's try somebody else. Brad.
Well, basically, parts of my story are a little R-rated, but I was in my last year of high school, and, the life of the party, but it wasn't enough.
Okay. That's good. Sort of the opposite of the other story, which is we want a more clear how to make these really effective. Okay. Jake, what about you?
Okay. Well, I grew up Catholic. Always sort of believed. But it wasn't until last year that when my mom died, my friend Anna, she told me about Jesus, and I gave my life to Christ with her. Jesus really saved me from myself.
You see, now that is great. Very specific, has both a how and a why. That is exactly what we were looking for. Thank you, Jake. That's great. Sparks, how about you?
Sorry we're late. We were at the house.
I said we were going to be out here, didn't I?
What are we doing, Eli?
I'll tell you what we're doing. You all are going to drop down and give me 20 push-ups. I'm serious. This isn't a joke. Drop down, 20 push-ups. Let's go. This isn't a joke. Let's go. Come on. Drop it. All right. Come on. Deeper.
Deeper. Deeper. Deeper. That's it. That's it. Deeper. Come on. Flip over. 20 sit-ups. Let's go. Come on.
Let's go, guys. Come on. Faster. Harder.
Spark says not a sit-up. I don't know what that is. Everybody up. Lap around the park. Go. 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 Now, 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 now. Go. 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 Now, now, now. Faster.
1 Corinthians 16:13. Ezekiel 1:7. Go.
1 Corinthians 13:4. Go. John 2:1. Go.
Philippians 5:6. Go.
Be strong in the faith.
Nope.
Offer yourself as a living sacrifice to God, dedicated to service and to pleasing.
Okay, good.
Alright, well done. If you don't know scripture, then you are going to be crippled for the rest of your life. Because it's easy to tell when the body is out of shape, but how do you tell when the soul is out of shape? Hmm? Okay, I'm gonna set my timer for 10 minutes. You have to get across this playground and capture the flag at the top of that tower. If you don't make it in time, you're running laps for the rest of the day. If you don't make it together, you're running laps for the rest of the day. And if a single one of you touches the ground, then you have to start all over. Capiche? Go!
Hey. Do you mind if we do this real quick? Supposed to be doing it every week.
Yeah.
Cool. Guess you've never done it before. It's super easy. It takes like 30 seconds. Alright. Have you masturbated this week?
I've done it once. Since we've got here. And you?
No. All right, next question. Have you made any inappropriate sexual comments?
No. And you?
No. And have you been reading your Bible and praying regularly?
Yeah, been praying.
And yes to me too. All right. See, that's not so hard. I'm gonna hop in the shower if you don't mind.
All right, guys, tomorrow is the big day. I want you to take a moment, close your eyes, a couple deep breaths, and picture Chicago. See the streets, the Willis Tower, the lake, the rows and rows of houses, the giant apartment buildings, all full of different people, different lives. And all of those people are broken, in need of Jesus, this whole city. We can't see into their houses, and we can't see into their lives, but we know they're there. But how many of them will be there on Judgment Day? Each of them is a mother, brother, a son, all in need of salvation.
Now I want you to think about your own life. The moment that you came to know Jesus. Now think about those streets again. All the people you walk past, the people you ignore. God wants them. God loves them. God wants to save them. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. All the earth is full of his glory. Amen.
You ready?
Yep.
Take this side.
Hi, ma'am. Would you like to take a survey? Want to take a survey?
Excuse me, interested in taking a spiritual survey? Survey? No.
Would you want to take a survey?
Hi, would you like to take a spiritual survey?
Would you mind taking a survey? Take a survey today? Sir, have time for a quick survey.
I agree with you. I'm just saying it's a problem I have. What? Is that you label things all the time, man? You try and put God into a box.
I'm not trying to put God in a box.
Huh?
Do you believe in the 5 points of Calvinism?
Oh, God. It's like...
Irresistible grace, yeah. Unconditional election, limited atonement, total depravity...
Total perseverance of the saints.
All right. So you've got them.
Yes, okay? I got them, and to an extent, I do believe in them.
And you're a Calvinist.
No, I'm a Christian.
Calvinism is just the name of the movement.
I'm just saying, man.
Don't put my God in the box.
All right, you guys need anything else?
No. We have everything we need.
All right.
Can I tell you why?
Sure, why?
Because ever since I gave my life to Jesus, I've had everything I need.
All right.
Hey, Jake, how are you?
Good.
It's Dad.
Yeah, I know.
Haven't heard from you in a while. Hope you're having fun.
Yeah, it's good. Really good.
What sort of things are you doing?
Lots of training and stuff. We pray, study, read the Bible. It's pretty intensive.
Interesting. Well, try not to get too caught up in everything. It's just a summer.
It's important.
Well, as long as you're not turning into a Republican.
What three words would you use to describe your life? On a scale of 1 to 10, rate your desire to know God. In your opinion, is the church relevant to our modern society?
To what?
To our modern society.
No.
No?
Well, not personally for me, but yeah, I'm sure to someone it is, but not to me.
Dude!
Yo!
Brad just led a guy to Christ.
Really?
Yes, sir.
How'd you do that?
We prayed together. He accepted Jesus into his heart. He's interested in the church. All right.
Yes.
What's going on, guys?
Brad just led a guy to Christ.
Nice job.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Hi.
Hi.
Would you be willing to take a quick survey? It's just a couple questions.
What's this survey for?
Oh, we're a new church in town, Bright Horizons.
Yeah, I'm really not that interested. Thank you.
I just want to let you know that God loves you. I didn't really know God until last year. After my mom, she passed away. My friend Anna really...
Excuse me, sorry.
Door is closing.
This stuff is really tough.
What are you struggling with?
I just feel so useless out here.
You're not useless. You're doing a great job, man. Just keep at it.
I mean, you always know what to do and what to say.
Well, you know, a lot of it has to do with really listening to God.
How do you listen to God?
Well, have you ever been baptized in the Spirit?
I don't think so.
Okay, well, you know when we're speaking in tongues? Yeah, we're being baptized in the Spirit then, okay? There's this idea of Pentecost and the Spirit being endowed within us.
How do you get that?
Can you just ask?
Know that I just wanna pray.
Okay, guys. First week down. How are we doing?
Good.
Any prayer requests today? Jake, what do you got, buddy?
I'd like to be baptized in the Holy Spirit.
Would you really? That's awesome. Okay, yeah, we can definitely pray for that, can't we?
Brother about to get filled.
Yeah. Well, come on up then. Let's do it, everybody.
Please, God.
Dear God, be with Jake. Pour your spirit onto Jake, God. Pour your spirit onto him.
Now, God, now. Please.
Come now, Lord. Come now.
Come now, Lord.
Come, God.
Please, God.
Come now, God.
Come now, Lord.
Now
come
is the time,
Jake.
God.
Come
now,
Jake,
God.
Please, Lord. Now.
Come now, God.
Now,
God. Come now,
Lord.
Now is the time, God.
Come now,
God.
Come now,
God.
Come now,
God.
Come now,
to Jake.
Thank you, Lord. Okay, Jake. How are you feeling? Hey, that's okay. That's okay. Sometimes it doesn't happen the first time. Just keep your heart open, all right?
Hey, man. End of the day, huh?
Yeah.
So, you down to grab some pizza?
I think I'm gonna stay here.
You sure?
Yeah.
All right. Text me if you change your mind, okay?
Excuse me. Excuse me. Hi. Listen, would you be willing to take a quick survey?
About what?
It's about religion and stuff.
Yeah, sure.
Can I get your name?
Gary Johnson.
Hi, Gary. I'm Jake. Can I ask you where you're from?
Gary, Indiana.
Gary from Gary? Okay, ready?
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
You think God punishes us?
I think
Jesus died for our sins. That's what we mean.
I know God, man. He punishes me, man. Dude, I was just robbed. This guy, he gave me these pills. And I just woke up, man, like an hour ago at the Barnes & Noble. He, like, took everything, man, my wallet and everything.
If I told you that we can be clean with God today, would you want to be?
Man, I'm not a good person, man.
That's not true. Gary, God loves you. You're his son. He wants you to be good. A new start. Would you want that?
Yeah, man, yeah, I think I would.
Can I?
Yeah, sure.
God, we come before you today, both as sinners. Both Gary and I have made mistakes, but you died for them. Gary, do you renounce your sin and give your life to Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Say it to God, Gary. Ask God for forgiveness.
God, I want to know you. Please forgive me.
He forgives you, Gary.
I was gonna die today, man.
God loves you.
God, I thought I was gonna die today.
If the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit who dwells in you.
Amen, Jake.
Amen. Almighty God, we love you. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Amen, Jake.
Bless you, God.
Amen, Jake.
Thank you, God.
Okay.
I know for the baby.
Chill.
Yeah. Get it out. What's Gabby doing?
I'm just checking up on things. Uh-oh, here they come.
Oh, my God.
Good morning.
Hi, guys.
How are we doing, guys?
Good.
Oh, you're okay,
how's your friends?
Oh, sweetie, I'm
sorry. Yeah. Oh, hi, guys. Looks like I should get to work.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Good morning. Good morning. How are we all doing?
I live. Yes, I've lived a life that's full. I travel each every highway. What more? Yeah, much more than me.
It go my way, shy way, this way or the highway. Shots to lay you off on your day off like Friday. The rock got yay, but they ain't snorting it. They just got them up the baseline recording shit. Yeah, I've been broke, now I'm good, bitch. I ain't no Kennedy, but I'm hood rich. So I say my way to thank you to the ghetto. And everybody else, thank you very little. I took the road less traveled, an unbeaten path. I've been beaten but not broken through the darkest past. It's sorta like when King spoke and said we free at last. Ain't nothing free from that point, dawg. We needed cash and we needed fast. We broke it then Ethiopians just trying to eat at last. Now all the blacks cooking up that almost white. Cause getting green make them treat us like we almost white. Almost, almost, almost.
Yes, I've lived a life that's full.
Go my way, shy way, this way or the highway. Niggas wanna discate on they local mixtapes. There they go again, lying to consumers. Get their head cut at the little shop of rumors. You're a little sloppy with your cockiness, ain't ya? A little arrogant with all your comparisons. Cause as far as the shy, I got the most plaque since the beginning of rap. But nah, y'all ain't mentioning that. That's just talk about my dough. How I left Chicago, how I'm the only one eating. Shut your pie hole and wanna figure out why I'm getting that high dough. Why? Cause you need fire and I'm a pyro. And you prepare it to copy what I do or say. Only difference between you and me, you were gay. Aww, did he get his feelings hurt? No, he got titties under his shirt.
I've lived. Yes, I've lived a life that's full. I travel each every highway. What more? Yeah, much more than this.
It go my way, shy way, this way or the highway. When you walk straight, niggas tend to look at you sideways. I say, fuck that dog, I get my own way. Niggas ain't believe me till they see me on TV and seen K. Relay. Getting head on the freeway, then pass it a freeway, just like it's a relay. We stay four stars or better, cause the couches in the rooms got more leather and we don't.
You masturbated this week?
Nope. And you?
Nope.
Viewed any pornography?
Nope. Have you?
Nope.
Been tempted by any of the women on the street?
No. How about you?
Nope.
Yeah.
Good job.
Hey, Jake. Come on out. Sit on down. Okay, sorry about that. How's it going? How's the summer going?
Really good.
Well, great. That's great. Well, you know, I don't have a lot of negative things to say about you. I can't think of anything, really. You've grown a lot. It's very clear to everyone. You're in the Word every day, man, and you're kind of on fire.
Thanks.
Yeah, totally, of course. I've been praying a lot about you, and I feel like you are definitely a great candidate for leadership of this church.
Really?
Absolutely, yeah. Is that something you've ever considered?
Well, I never really thought about it.
Well, I mean, it's not an easy road.
It's a calling for sure. It's more than just a job. So I hope you'll do some praying about that and talk to me about it. If you have questions, I'm happy to talk about it.
Thank you.
So I have to ask you, have you been masturbating or looking at porn at all?
No.
Okay, good. Good.
Hey, Phil! Phil! Ball! Phil, come in! Get the ball! Phil, come on!
No, I'm fine. You guys have fun.
Hey, how's the water?
It's great. How are your emails?
I'm good.
Hey, Dad.
Jake, how are you? How's Chicago?
Yeah, it's great. We're at the beach right now.
Oh, great. Listen, you got a minute?
Yeah.
Okay. Your Aunt Carol called. She and Max would love to see you tonight. That is, if you're free. Should I tell her you're free?
Jake, welcome.
Great.
Good to see you. Man, you got big.
Yeah, you're so tall. Great, have a seat. Make yourself at home. Spaghetti a la Carol and Max. Mm-hmm. There you go.
Yes. So, have you had a chance to check out the sights yet, you know, explore Chicago a little bit?
Yeah, we did that in the first week, but that's not why we're really here.
Mm. What sort of things have you been doing?
We're talking to people about Jesus and trying to change their lives like he's changed ours.
How do you do that?
Well, we're out on L stops, like, all day, trying to talk to some people.
Sounds tough.
That's interesting.
I was a bit nervous at first, but I feel like I've grown so much in the past few months.
That's great.
You know, we have a church preview coming up in a couple weeks. You guys should come.
Maybe. So, how's college, school?
I don't know, I don't have a major yet. I don't think college is my thing. It's really good.
Good, I'm glad you like it.
Thank you.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
What's up?
I'm Jake.
Hi, Jake. I'm Clara.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. I'm sorry, am I crowding you?
Oh, no.
Okay.
I'm just seeing what you were for.
Oh, yeah. This is Snap. It's for LGBTQ youth.
Oh, cool. Yeah.
What about you? What's this?
Spiritual surveys.
Spiritual surveys. Interesting.
We're a new church in town.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Well, nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, Jake.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Your signatures.
Keep at it, okay? I see bright horizons in your future. Right?
Yeah.
Bye.
Philip? Hey. Who's this?
I don't know. You're the one that talked to him.
Yeah, but you filled out the survey.
Guys, can I ask you something?
Sure.
I feel like I'm supposed to talk to that girl over there. Well, I'm really nervous. I don't know why.
Since when are you nervous to talk to someone?
Does that sound like God to you?
Yeah. I think you gotta put yourself out there and see what happens.
This is Courtney. With a C. Then Orton. I don't remember talking to Courtney.
Already a Christian.
Philly? Guess not.
What?
She's gay.
So what?
She's acting on her desires. That's a sin.
It's only mentioned in the Old Testament a handful of times.
But Paul writes about it.
You
see,
sure?
You've read it.
You've read about it, but what's your point?
Why is it okay for them to act on their sexual desires? It's not okay for us.
Hey guys.
Hey.
How's it going?
Hey, here you are.
Working hard? Doing alright?
What's Bright Horizon's position on gay people?
What do you mean?
Is it a sin to be gay?
You know, my heart, it breaks for LGBTQ people because they think the church hates them, but the church actually loves them. The thing is that the Bible draws a very clear portrait of sexuality, and just as it's bad for you or me to masturbate or look at porn, it's bad for them to act on their sexual urges. Take Drew, for example. Jake and Phil's host. Drew is one of my best friends in Bright Horizons. We have known each other for years. He identifies as gay, but believes that his sexuality gets in the way of his relationship with Jesus. And so he's celibate. The hard truth is, we can't pick and choose what parts of the Bible we want to be true. So is that cool? We good? Wisconsin.
Hey.
What's going on? Just got off of work. Wasn't there two of you?
Oh, Phil is at the other guy's house.
Ah. Okay.
Eli said he told you guys about me.
Yeah.
So you have any questions?
No.
All right. Breakfast is 7 a.m. sharp. Don't play your rap music too loud.
Hey guys, sorry to keep you waiting. I got a little go juice for ya. Energize yourselves, help yourselves. Okay, go ahead.
Where's Sparks, Eli?
Sparks had to go home. He's not gonna be with us anymore, all right?
Couldn't hack it.
Okay, so let's do a little status update for the summer. I would say that numbers-wise, we are not exactly where we want to be right now, but, you know, it just feels like we're getting a little lazy. These surveys are, they're okay, but the work's a bit sloppy. This one doesn't even have a phone number. God is trusting us with these people. I mean, what's going on, guys? Why are we getting lazy about this stuff? Hmm?
Okay, I feel like I have this constant, you know, this constant struggle inside of me with my purity, you know? Like when we're out there, it's on my mind all the time. And when we're not out there, when we're in here, it's bugging me constantly and I just can't get it out of my head. And it's making me lose my focus in a way that is, I don't know, it's not cool to you guys. And you know, it's not cool to me. I'm sorry about that.
Okay. I get it. That's something we need to work on. As such, we have a couple initiatives that we're starting that I think we're gonna help jumpstart things and get us moving in the right direction. One is that thanks to Sarah's idea, we now have a relationship with a local grocery store. But anyone who fills out this survey with a phone number gets entered in a raffle for $100 of free meat. That's good. People like to talk that up. The other thing is that we have all of these whistles. Pass these things out. Pass them out like candy. I have a ton of them. I have too many of them. So make sure people get these. They have the email address, the name of the church. It's all good. All right?
Hey, Eli?
Yeah?
Who's going to be playing guitar now?
You play guitar? Phil is gonna play guitar now.
Sorry.
All right, so let's get going.
Phil? What? What time is it? Phil.
I know. I'm really sorry, all right? I've been praying about it for the past 30 minutes. I feel really bad. Thank you for not freaking out on me. Well, this is why we're accountability buddies. We gotta hold each other accountable for these sort of things. Actually, would you mind praying with me? Just real quick. It would make me feel a lot better.
Sure.
Guy that I knew 6 months ago who wasn't even sure if he wanted to come here. Yeah, you can get out there. Go ahead.
Hey. Eli wanted me to come with.
All right.
What are we doing?
Trying to pray with someone. Come on.
What?
Hi. I'm Jake. And Phil.
My name is Abigail.
Nice to meet you guys. Are you enjoying the park?
Yes.
I don't know how to say this really, but I feel the need to pray for both of you, if that's okay.
Yes.
I can afford to eat a delicious strawberry.
Lord, we know you can put skin on dry bones. You can raise an army from the dead. You, in the name of Jesus Christ, to heal Abigail,
to make her walk again.
Lord, please, God, be with Abigail. Please heal her.
Hey, man, what was that?
I don't know, just thought, give me some space.
Hey Jake, can you take over? I gotta pee.
Guys, this is incredible. Sarah counted these last night, and we got 500 names and numbers at the fair on Saturday. Woo! Okay, so what we're going to do today is we're actually going to stay in. You're going to call these people and you're going to follow up with them. Make sure they know that they are invited to the church preview on Wednesday. All right? Get to work.
Hi, is that Michelle? Sorry, Mitchell.
Hey, Eli.
Hey, check these out. Wow, it's like we're a real church now. Oh, I'm sorry. What were you saying?
No, it's all right. It's fine.
Okay. Well, hit those phones, bud. All right.
Doing surveys because we want to tell what people believe and stuff.
Right, and you know, get their email.
Yeah.
It's okay. I get it, really. So do me. Come on, do the survey. Hey. Yay!
Okay. Question one. What three words would you use to describe your life?
What three words would I use to describe my life? I don't know, spontaneous, passionate, involved, I guess. Those sound really lame.
No, no.
Is this like one of those personality tests?
No.
Okay.
Question two. What happens after death?
Are you serious? Whatever, I'll answer. I don't think anything happens after death.
Nothing?
Nope.
Why do you think that?
I don't know, no one's come back from the dead and you know, told me otherwise.
I'm just... Doesn't that depress you?
What?
Thinking that there's nothing out there?
I don't know. Yes, death scares me, but it also just makes me want to live in the moment, you know?
Right.
I really should be, you know, getting back.
Okay.
But, this is my phone number. And if you ever leave your crazy church, you should give me a call. Bye.
Hey Jake, can you come over here for a second?
Here you go. You got it. All right.
Hey. Hey, buddy. So listen, I'm looking for some kind of, you know, podium or a music stand, maybe, just something I can put my notes on. Would you help me find that?
Yeah, do you have a key?
I don't. So just whatever's open is open, all right?
All right.
Great.
Seems good. Quiet. We haven't, been in this area since high school. You said you wanted to have a conversation?
Yeah, I guess I had a couple questions. I know you're a Christian.
I'm a Jesus freak. It's okay. You can call me that.
I remember, I think it was our sophomore year. When your uncle died suddenly, you always seemed, even through that, to really have it together. Not that it didn't affect you, but you were still happy.
Jake, I don't know what it's like to lose a parent, but I do know that God's gotten me through a lot of terrible things so far. I know that no matter what happens, he's right by my side. And I believe he does that for everyone.
I guess I really never thought about that.
Would it be weird if I prayed for you right now?
I don't know.
Do you ever pray?
So, not really.
Can I pray with you now? If that's okay? Only if it's okay.
Okay.
Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for Jake. Thank you for our friendship. I thank you, God, that you are my light, my rock, my redeemer. Lord, be with Jake now. He's not sure you're there, God, but I know you are. You can say something if you want.
God,
it's okay. Just say what's on your mind.
God, I want to know you're there. If you are God, and you made everything, I want to know you.
Yes, God.
Please, God. Please. I want to know you're there.
Thank you, God.
Excuse me. What is this?
Church preview.
Oh. Can't see one of the flyers.
So I'd first like to start by thanking St. Anthony's for hosting us today. We're still putting the few final touches on our own beautiful place, so we will be there soon enough. But thank you to St. Anthony's for your generous hospitality. And then I'd also like to thank all of you for coming out. I know it's been a scorcher today, so it's much appreciated. We are Bright Horizons. We're the new church in town. At the back, you'll find our merch table. We have a lot of goodies back there. We have shirts and bags and those fancy coffee cups. So take some of those with you. Those are for you. I'd like to ask you a question. What is community? Now, don't get me wrong. I get it. Life is hard, it's stressful, things can bring you down, but the important thing to remember, people, is that it doesn't have to be this way. As Christians, we believe that Jesus died and rose again so that we might live. Imagine for me, if you will, a canyon. We here on earth are imperfect, but God, on the other hand, he is perfect. We want to be with God, and God wants to be with us, but we can't because of sin. Sin is what inhabits the canyon between us. Thankfully, we have found a pathway across sin. And it is Jesus Christ. Jesus lived, died, and rose again for our sins. Here at Bright Horizons, that is what we are all about. We are about him. Isn't that right, Phil? Come on up, Phil.
Please stand.
fitting in? You showing them the ropes?
Yeah.
I mean, it's mostly been Eli.
No way.
I'm actually showing him the
ropes. Dude! How's it going, Phil?
It's going really well. How are you?
I'm doing great. Great to see you. Good to be back in the Midwest.
So, guys, I know I don't need to introduce this guy because you already know him, but this is Dan Fogelman.
Woo! Danny!
Wow. All right, that's enough.
Well, maybe a little more. Come on. Let me hear
you. You rascal, you rascal. Right. So, Dan Fogelman.
Thank you.
The founding pastor of Bright Horizons St. Louis, Bright Horizons Milwaukee, a close personal friend and mentor of mine. And even though Dan is in the middle of his own church plant in Phoenix, he agreed to come out here and give us the old kick in the pants. So no further ado, Dan Fogelman.
Thanks, Eli. Thank you. Wow. I don't deserve all this applause, but I'll take it. I'm excited. I founded the Milwaukee chapter of Bright Horizons with eight families in a living room just like this. Eight families. There are over 2,000 people now in Bright Horizons, Milwaukee. 2,000 people. You're going to need a bigger living room.
Sure am.
But that's a good problem to have, right?
I think so, yeah.
Hey, Jake, right?
Yeah.
Dan Fogelman. I think I know everyone here but you. How you doing?
Good.
Eli tells me you're interested in the ministry. Is that true?
Yeah, I've been thinking about it.
I think that's great. And listen to Eli. He's a smart guy. Let me give you a card here. He speaks very highly of you. You in college now?
Yeah.
What are you studying?
I don't really know yet.
No. Not yet. That seems like the answer of the millennials. They're not sure what they want to do yet. And you know what? That's a good thing. There's nothing wrong with that. Can I give you some advice?
Mm-hmm.
Take a year off. You know, work with one of our churches. It's a great way to learn how to serve. You cut the grass. You help out with Bible study. It's a really enriching experience, and I highly recommend it.
Yeah.
You know, people ask me, they say, Dan, why is Christianity shrinking? The problem is, guys, there's a lack of men in the church. Not a lack of males, a lack of men. See the difference? Our men have been pacified, sissified, turned into limp-wristed hippies, too ashamed to stand up for God.
Amen.
No. See, that's what I'm talking about right there. I've been preaching for 15 years, and the amount of amens I hear with no follow-through is astounding. You wave your hands every Sunday. But when the world's culture goes and changes and says, homosexuality is fine, are you going to change too? Are you going to have the moral attention span of a squirrel? What are you willing to do? What are you willing to sacrifice? You willing to move your family to a new city like Eli did? If we want the church to rise again, we men must rise first. You need to ask yourselves, what kind of men are you going to be? But right now, we're going to worship. And I want you all to be broken before the Lord. Anyone got a problem with that? Hey! Come on. Jake! What's going on? Jake, come on. That's not how brothers treat each other. Just calm down and let's talk about it.
my dad?
Hey, okay, Jake, how are you?
Not so good.
Okay.
I lost my Zoloft, and I'm kind of freaking out right now.
Okay. Let's just figure something out.
Hello?
Buddy. Hey, you all right? Special delivery for you, sir. Get you some water. Do you want me to make you some dinner?
Sounds good.
Okay.
This is it. End of the summer. And this Sunday is the first service of the Bright Horizons Chicago Church. That's fantastic. Yeah. It's all thanks to your hard work. You've grown a lot as men of Christ this summer, and I gotta say that I am proud of each and every one of you. Our next step is to take this strength with us wherever we go. Agreed?
Yeah.
All right. Now, I don't want to end the summer on a sour note, but there is something that we need to talk about just so that everything's out in the open. Jake? Philip here told me that you two got in a fight the other day. Is that true? Well, Philip, you want to elaborate on this for us?
Jake walked out on a conversation we were having with a stranger. And when I tried to catch up with him and pray, he just threw me on the sidewalk.
Do you have a response to that, Jake?
Sorry.
Oh, come on, man. We're not the sorry police. We are men of Christ. Philip, do you want to say anything else?
Well, Jake, you've had a great summer. You've grown a lot, and that's apparent. But I think you need to work on a couple things, okay? Now, that being said, I forgive you for what happened the other day, all right?
I know this is harsh, Jake, but you said that you want to be a leader of the church, so I'm going to treat you like one, all right? Guys, I think the best thing that we can do for Jake right now is to just pray for him. Yeah. Can we do that together?
Yeah.
All together?
Yeah.
All right. Dear God,
be with us now.
Yes, be with us, God. Be with us,
God. Here in this room.
Jake, God, please, I'm
and here with Jake.
Please help us, God.
Jake.
We are all sinners. None of us are perfect.
All sinners.
All of us.
We want salvation.
Please, God.
Show us the way, God.
Please, God. Please, God.
Jake.
Jake.
Your future. You are destined for greatness, Jake.
Yes, Jake. Yes, God.
Thank you, God, for Jake.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jake.
Thank
you for your light. Thank you for your power.
Thank you, God.
Thank you for your guidance.
I love you, God.
Show us the way, God.
Yes, God. Show us the way.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God. Help us, God. Be with us, God.
Lead us.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, God. Show us the light.
You are the future.
Show him
you
the
are
light.
Our light.
Give it to him.
Yes.
Give him the light. Give him the light.
Glorious future with you.
Show him the light.
Yes.
Thank you, God.
No, you're right. Hey, can I call you right back? All right. So, is this the end?
Yep.
Back to Wisconsin. Keep in touch, Jakey. You can use these thumbs, you know.
I will.
I hope so. Look. You smell like my laundry detergent. I didn't say you could use that. I was joking.